Good morning, children. How are you all? Hope you're all doing well. Today we are going to learn a new lesson from supplement reader, that is the desert. When you hear the word desert, what image comes to your mind? Yes, you are absolutely right. It is a vast stretch of sand with no vegetation. Now let us know more about this desert. Those of us who live in regions covered with forest and surrounded by hills may find it difficult to imagine what a desert is really like. That is, people who live in forest and also surrounded by hills, they find it very difficult to imagine what a desert is really like or how a desert looks like. The popular belief is that it is an endless stretch of sand where no rainfall and therefore no vegetation grows. So that is a popular belief by the people. It is that they think, or it is a popular belief that by the people is that they think that it is an endless stretch of sand and no rainfall also, and also no vegetation. That means no plants grow there. So that is the popular belief of people. It is dry, hot, waterless and without shelter. But this is not entirely correct. So that is, this desert is dry, hot and also waterless and also without shelter. People, they think it, but this is not correct. For those who have studied it, the desert can be a beautiful place. It is the home of a variety of people, animals and plants that have learned to live under very hot and dry conditions. So for the people who have studied about this desert, they think or they know that it is a very beautiful place on the earth, and also it is a home for a variety of people and animals and also plants, and they adjust to the very hot and dry climate conditions. They learned how to live in this particular area. True, the ground is not always hidden by a cover of grass, plants and trees as it is in other climates. That is, it is true that the desert is not covered with grass, not with plants also, neither with trees, and as it is in other climates. In other climates, all this you find it, but in desert, it is not like that. But whenever it rains, which is rare, desert flowers bloom and the sight can be as rewarding as that of any tropical garden. But children, when it rains in desert, you can see here in the picture how the cactus flowers, it bloomed. So it is a very rewarding as that of any tropical garden. A desert is not always a flat, unchanging wasteland of dry sand. It may have mountains and hills. It may have an oasis, big or small. An oasis is like a green island in the middle of a desert where a spring or a well gives plants and trees a better chance to grow. So here, desert, it is not always a flat one. So it is not flat. Okay, it will change. It is an unchanging wasteland of dry sand. So you can see in desert dry sand, and it always changes. And this you can see here, children, in the picture, mountains will be there, even hills also. And also in the other picture, you can see there is an oasis. That is, either it can be big or small. So now let us know what this oasis is. Oasis is like a green island. You can see it is green island, that is in the middle of the desert, where a spring or a well gives plants and trees a better chance to grow. So as this oasis in the middle of the desert, it helps the plants and the trees to grow. A desert may be not hot like the Thar or cold like Ladakh, but generally speaking, if a place has little or no water and vegetation, people usually call it a desert. So a desert may be not hot like the Thar. So a desert may be hot like the Thar. So Thar desert, you all know it. It is in Rajasthan. So it is hot. It will be hot only. Or cold like Ladakh, which is in Jammu Kashmir. But generally speaking, children, if a place has little or no water and vegetation, people usually call it a desert. So generally people speak saying that in desert, the vegetation is less. Okay. And no water. And that they think it as a desert. But even in desert, when there is a When there is a rainfall, you can find the cactus bloom, isn't it? Some deserts are almost totally without water. In such places, strong winds blow, raising heaps of sand and depositing them as mounds. These are called sand dunes that shift and move endlessly across the desert. Few plants can survive on such dry, shifting sands. So here, some deserts are almost totally without water. So you can see here the two pictures which are there here, no water here. So where there is no water, there you find strong winds blow. And when the strong winds blow, okay, then you can see the sand moving from one place to another place. It is rising from one place to another place, and it rises from one place and it gets deposited in the another place. And that when it gets deposited, it is called as a mound. So mound is like a big heap. Okay, so that is called as a sand dune. So now these sand dunes, they won't be at one place. They go on shifting from one place to another place in the desert. Why they shift? Because of the strong winds. So few plants can survive on such dry, shifting sand. So here in the sand dunes, or here in this desert, you can see some plants which are surviving. All living things need water in order to survive. The few plants and animals that live in deserts have developed the ability to require less water than most plants and animals. So here, we know that all the living creatures, they need water. So why do we need water? We need to survive. For that, we need water. So the few plants and animals that live in deserts, okay, even they also have the ability to require less water. So as they are in the desert, they got habituated or developed the ability to take less water than most plants and animals. So compared to the other plants and animals, they have developed the ability to take less water. Now coming to the camel. The camel, popularly known as the ship of the desert, can drink a lot of water at one time. So we all know that it drinks gallons of water and it stores the water. Camel can do without water for days together. That means camel can live without water for so many days because it stores the water. The reason is they sweat very little. We sweat because we must keep our body temperature constant. So here the camels, they don't sweat, or they sweat very little compared to us. So when we sweat, we keep our body temperature. When we are sweating, so that sweat, it keeps our body temperature constant. Whereas this camels, they sweat very little compared to us. So we sweat when it gets hot and this cools the body. So when we sweat, when are we going to sweat? When it is very hot outside. At that time, we sweat a lot. So when we sweat a lot, that sweat, it makes our body cool. Camels can stand high body temperature. So camel can withstand with high body temperature, means they can absorb lot of heat. Okay. They don't need to sweat and can therefore retain the water they drink for long periods of time. So here, these camels, they don't need to sweat. Okay, they needn't sweat and can therefore, whatever the water which they drank, they retain it. Okay, they use that later, which they drink for longer periods of time. The smaller desert animals do not drink water. Now coming to the other animals which are there in desert, that is the smaller animals, they don't drink water. They burrow under ground during the hot day and come out at night to eat. Now here you can see the pictures of some of the animals, desert animals. Okay, so what they do, they dig, they burrow themselves during the hot day, during morning, and they come out at night. So why do they burrow themselves during the hot day? To escape from the heat, and nighttime they come out to eat. Some of them eat other animals and get the water they need from the moisture in the meat. So some animals, what they do it, they eat other animals. Okay, so when they eat the other animal, there will be moisture. Moisture is the wetness will be there in the meat. So that is enough for them to survive. Others eat plants and seeds and get the water they need from plant juices. So other animals like camels and other animals, they eat the plants, or else even seeds also they eat. So in plants and seeds, they come across some sort of moisture or the plant juices. With that, they survive. Desert plants also adapt themselves to the life they lead. Cactus plants store water in their thick stems. Their roots lie close to the surface of the ground and quickly absorb the moisture from the light rains that occasionally fall. So here, desert plants also adapt themselves to the life they lead. So the plants, the desert plants which are there in the desert, they also adapt themselves. They also adjust themselves to the climatic conditions. And coming to this cactus plant, you can see cactus plant here. They store water in their thick stems. The stems which they have, those are very thick. In that thick stem, they store the water. And also, their roots lie very close to the surface of the ground. Means very close to the surface, their roots are there. They are not very deep. Okay. So as the roots are very close to the surface of the ground, they can quickly absorb the moisture. Moisture from the light rains. So light, if there is a light rainfall, occasionally very light rainfall, these roots of the cactus, they absorb the moisture. So why they absorb the moisture very quickly? Because they are not very, their roots are not so deep. They are very close to the surface. So with that thing, they absorb the moisture from the light rains which fall in desert. The major feature of all deserts is, of course, dryness and variations of temperature. So now major feature of desert, what it is? Dryness. Everywhere it will be totally dry. And variation of temperature. So variation is changes. So the temperature changes. Okay, in humid climates, so humid refers to containing moisture. In humid climates, the moisture in the air acts like a blanket and protects the earth's surface from the hot rays of the sun. So when there is a moisture in the air, okay, so that moisture in the air, how does it act? It acts like a blanket. So why does it act like a blanket? In order to protect the earth's surface. Okay, so it protects the earth's surface from what does it protect? From the hot rays of the sun. So this blanket, that is the moisture in the air, that protects the hot rays of the sun. So the absence of this blanket in desert land causes the desert to heat up rapidly during the day and to cool off rapidly at night. So now in desert, we don't have this sort of blanket. So what is this blanket? That is the moisture in the air that is totally absent in desert. So as it is absent in desert, that blanket or the moisture in the air, which protects the earth's surface, that is the hot rays of the sun, that is totally absent in desert. So when it is not there, this desert, it heats up rapidly. Rapidly means very quickly it gets heated during the day, and very quickly, as how quickly it gets heat up, like that, very quickly it cools off at night. Now you can see the pictures here. Deserts are an important part of nature's great plan. They are there like the dense forest and the deep oceans. So now these deserts are very much important. Okay. And they are there like the dense forest. Means dense forest refers to thick forest. So as we have thick forest and deep oceans, like that we have deserts. So these deserts are also very important part of nature. Just because they are hot and dry, one should not look upon them as useless parts of the earth. So here it is said that as they are very hot and dry, we should not think that they are useless parts of the earth. So from this lesson, what do we learn, children? What we have learned from this lesson? Yes, these deserts play a very important role in nature's cycle of life. So just because they are hot and dry, we should not ignore them as they are useless parts of the earth. So in the same way in our life, similarly, we should not ignore anyone whom we meet in our life. Is this clear, children? Thank you.